Hello and welcome to SternFX. I'm Eran Stern, and in this tutorial, I'll share my recipe to create a scanner darkly look using Photoshop and After Effects. Now, in case you didn't hear about this movie, A Scanner Darkly from 2006 was written and directed by Richard Linklater, and it is based on a novel by the same name by Philip K. Dick. The film tells the story of identity and deception in a near-future dystopia constantly under intrusive high-tech police surveillance in the midst of a drug addiction epidemic. Now, this film was shot digitally and then animated using interpolated rotoscope, in which animators traced over original footage frame by frame to achieve this distinctive animated look. So in this tutorial, I'll use the trailer as a reference and try to recreate the look and feel of this movie using built-in tools and effects in After Effects and Photoshop. Now, I must say that my result will not look as articulated and detailed as the movie. As I mentioned, for this movie, as well as for Waking Life, the movie that came 5 years before it, the creators used their own proprietary application, which was built for this purpose. So what I'm offering here is the next best thing, a semi-automated approach. And if you want to learn more about the entire rotoscoping process, stick until the end and I'll give you some links. But for now, let's show my recipe that should work on any clip with minor tweaks depending on the footage that you'll use. Okay, enough with the disclaimers and the introductions. Let's see how to make it happen. So I'll start here in After Effects. I have few clips under this footage folder. I'll grab these cornfield scientists and create a composition out of it. First, let's take a look. We have a couple of scientists examining corn in a cornfield. Lovely. All right, I'll pause the playback, go to the beginning, then go to the composition menu, choose composition settings, and then I'll change the frame rate to something lower. I found out that 10 frames per second is a good starting point. So I'll choose that number and I'll click OK. Now I'll zoom out and then I'll shorten this composition by changing the work area and then right click on it and choose trim comp to work area. So this is what we have now, a bit more cartoonish style when it comes to the frame rate. Now I'm going to render this clip and this is going to serve us as the fill layer inside Photoshop. So I'll add this to the render queue, and you can also use a keyboard shortcut, Command Control M here on the Mac side. I'm going to click over here, place this guy on the desktop, and I'm also going to create a new folder for this and name it Clips. I'll remove the two suffix and just add the word fill, click save, and then hit the render button. Next, I'll return back to the working composition and I'll go to Effect, Stylize, and add the cartoon effect. I'll change the render to just render the edges and I'll change the edge threshold to 2 and then tab to the edge width and change it to 2 as well. Now, depending on the contrast in the clip that you are using, you may need to tweak those values. But I'm going to settle for this one, and then I'll add this version again to the render queue, this time by using the keyboard shortcut, and then I'll click again over here, I'll remove the two, and I'll call this one Edge. And then I'll click Save and Render. Next, I'll bring Photoshop to the front, and I'll go to File, and choose Open as Smart Object. I'll navigate to where I just saved those clips, and let's begin with the Edge version. I'll click Open, and I need to create a timeline for it. So I'll go to Window, and then choose Timeline, and then switch this to Create Video Timeline, and click on it. And this is going to place the clip inside a smart object, because this is what we've used in order to open it, and we'll place it in this timeline, meaning that I can now apply filters and they are going to be applied to every frame in this video. And the filter that I want to apply is under stylized, and it is the oil paint filter. Now in the brush stylization, I'll set it to its maximum value of 10, as well as the next value, the cleaningless. I'm just going to drag it all the way to 10, and then I'll switch off the lighting. I'll click OK, and this is how it looks. Now I'll export it as a video so I can use it later inside After Effects. So I'll go to the timeline menu options, and then I'll select render video. I'll select the same folder. So here it is inside those clips. Photoshop will add a -1 suffix, which is totally fine. I'm not going to use anything over here. I'm just going to click render and let Photoshop process this file. It will take a few moments, and now we are ready to prepare the fill layer. So I'm going to go again to File, Open as Smart Object, and then I'll choose the fill video that we've exported from After Effects. I'll click Open, and same thing, I need to create a video timeline. So the effect that we are going to use here, actually the filter, is going to be applied to all the frames. And the filter is under the filter gallery. So go ahead and open it. And we need to open up the artistic folder and click on poster edges. Now, depending again on the contrast that you have, you may need to tweak those values. But the one that I end up using were 2 for the edge thickness. I'm going to lower the edge intensity to 0, and I'll leave the posterization at 2. So almost the default values. I'll click OK, and then just verify that it was applied to the entire footage. And I'm going to repeat the same process. So I'll go to the option menu, choose render video. I'll point it to the same directory. I'm not going to change anything here. Just click render and let Photoshop process the file. Now I'll return back to After Effects. I'll go to the project window. I'll close the render queue as well as this composition. And then I'm going to double click to import those 2 files that I just exported from Photoshop. So the edges and the fill with the -1, these are the versions that we want to composite over here. I'm going to drag them again to an empty portion in the composition panel and ask After Effects to create a single composition out of them. I'll click OK. I'm going to dismiss the audio. We don't have any audio anyhow. And then I'll select the upper layer, which is the edge, and I'll switch the blending mode to multiply. And then I'll select the lower version, which is the fill, go to effect, go under color correction, apply the curves effect. I'm going to raise the gamma to make it a bit more cartoonish and bring back the intensity of the clip. And because I want to restore the liveliness, I'll head back to the color correction category and I'll add the vibrance effect, and I'll set the vibrance to 100. And this is it. I'll play for you the result and even maximize the composition panel by pressing the tilde or grav key so you can see it in more detail. So this is one example. Let's head back to the project panel. And then I'll show you a few other examples. So first I'll show you the untreated clips. Let's start with those warehouse workers. So this is the original footage. I'll double click on this composition with the same name. And this is after the same treatment that I just showed you. Very close to the appearance of the movie. Let's see another example. These are the smartphone couple. Again, the untreated version, and this is how it came out from Photoshop and composed here inside After Effects using the oil paint effect combined with the poster edges. And last but not least, we have 2 scientists in the lab trying to come up with a solution to a pandemic. And this is how it looks after the same treatment. Let's go to the beginning and preview the composition. So this is my approach to create a similar look, and you are welcome to test it yourself and also suggest how you may improve it in the comments below. For now, I want to thank you for watching this tutorial, and if you want to see more, consider subscribing to the channel and maybe also like this video. Now, if you want to learn more about rotoscoping, I have a full course on LinkedIn Learning devoted to this topic where I explore several techniques to isolate elements for compositing and visual effects work using various of professional applications such as Mocha, Silhouette, Character Animator, and of course, After Effects. The link is down below. So do check it out, but this is it for now. I want to thank you again for your time, and I will see you in the next one.